Hi, John here. In this video, we're going to have a look at wind turbines. We'll talk about what the wind is and what causes it. We'll then look at how we can extract the kinetic energy from the wind and convert it into electrical energy. We'll look at the different classifications of wind turbine, the different common designs. Then we'll take a look at the typical components that a wind turbine has, such as the blades, nacelle, tower, etc. And finally, we'll have a look at exactly how we can take the electrical energy from a wind turbine and feed it into our electrical grid. You can see on this 3D model that we've got a wind farm. A wind farm simply means that we've got a collection of wind turbines, like you can see here, and they're all generating power from the wind. We're farming the energy from the wind. But what causes wind? Well, wind is simply the movement of air. And this movement of air is created due to pressure differences within our atmosphere. When we have low pressure, it's because the air has been heated by the sun. The air is rising up through the atmosphere. When we have a high pressure, the air is cooling and will descend in the atmosphere. Whenever we have a pressure difference within a system, these pressures will try and equalize. As the pressure equalizes, we'll get the high pressure area moving into the low pressure area. The process is continuous. Depending upon the pressure difference, we will get either a rapid movement of air from the high pressure area to the low pressure area, or perhaps it will happen more gradually. The larger the pressure difference, the more movement we're going to get, and as a result, the more wind we will get. If you want to visualize this a bit more simply, just think of natural convection. As some air is heated, it will move up because it's less dense, and the cooler air, which is more dense, will displace it. It's this displacement that's actually going to push the less dense air upwards. Once it rises upwards, it cools again, drops down, and the cycle repeats. It's what we call natural convection. And this is what's happening in the Earth's atmosphere on a much larger scale. So we know now that wind is caused by a pressure difference in the atmosphere, which is caused by the heat energy from the sun. How are we going to harness the kinetic energy from the wind, the movement energy from the wind, and turn it into electrical power? Here we can see a wind turbine in operation. See there, it's slightly changed position as it tracks the wind. Let's have a look at some of the main parts. We've got a tower, which is what our wind turbine rotor and nacelle sit upon. The nacelle is this item here. It's the box, effectively, that contains all the parts we need to take the kinetic energy from the wind and convert it to electrical energy. And then we've got our rotor, which is the rotor hub and the blades. The blades will be manufactured from fiberglass. Some might be manufactured from wood. Some an epoxy resin mixture. It really depends upon the size of the blade and the conditions in which it will be operating. Here we've got three separate blades and they will attach to our rotor hub. This is actually a rotor hub cover. We can remove it and you can see the rotor underneath. Wind will come from this direction. It will blow over the rotor. It will actually move in this direction. So it blows over the rotor and then along the nacelle and away. We extract the kinetic energy from the wind using the blades, and we do this by converting the wind's kinetic energy into a force known as lift. You can see that the blades have quite an unusual design. If I spin them around here, you can see they're not cylindrical or rectangular in shape, they're actually slightly twisted. This particular shape is known as an airfoil. It's a very special shape that we use a lot within engineering. We use it for wind turbines, we use it for hydro turbines, we use it for ships' propellers, we even use it for Formula One cars. The reason that we use this shape, the airfoil shape, in fact we just call it an airfoil, is because we want to generate lift. Now lift is a force that occurs when a fluid flows over an airfoil. When a fluid flows over an airfoil, we convert the kinetic energy into lift. Lift acts perpendicular to the flow direction, and we use different shapes of airfoil depending upon the fluid and the fluid velocity. Formula One cars want to generate lift in order to press the car onto the road so that the car can travel around corners faster. laws of conductor, then it makes sense to save on materials. Aside from that, it's simply more efficient to increase the voltage and reduce the current, because when we do this, we reduce our power losses. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you'd like to learn more about engineering or teach using the 3D models that are shown in this video, then please do visit saVRee.com. We've got over 50 hours of video courses and over 400 fully interactive 3D models. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel. Thank you very much for your time.